Kakan hun kitrai mon sungoba bat kitrai bar gila sei ya kikali kentup ya kikali barem baja banyak kelenggari India nak benda belum jingarap nak benda kibriu kiba syakta hak kelam COVID-19 kene kejing ya bala ait keteng kum karut ashram ne kejing ya bet hasurok hala kikali lajong kalapoi hanong ba shilong menta kasngi ka sautari ur nei weng arajar arpo ban pin sung thu lang ya kinong shong shinong ne kejela halor kijing e baki pat ba ke kendu nak ne ka kelam kinong yalam ngani kakin hun kilaya thu baki layat gomba lai putli kijela kan thup ru ikap pot jongkari nepal halor kane kejing thungu ka jongki
We were also staying at home during the lockdown, and we were, you know, very privileged that we were not needed to worry about our next meal, what will happen tomorrow. However, during that time, we have seen on TV and read in the newspaper the distressing stories about lakhs of migrant workers. They were walking long distances to return to their home. It was not that we were not aware about their distress, but this pandemic has created a platform where their distress has been showcased. Like responsible citizens and sensitive, you know, human beings, we were also moved and carried away by those footages, and we wanted to do something, you know, some help. So we did whatever we could in our individual capacity, but we thought that it is important that we take an extra stay. That's how we started thinking, and the concept of Road Ashram came in this beautifully crafted car. Three of us are traveling 25,000 kilometers. Amar is our driver in chief. He is driving all the you know, the entire journey. We are traveling 25,000 kilometers, crossing 30 states and union territories, and we started on 4th of October. We are traveling along the India's borders. So from Delhi we moved to Uttarakhand, touched the China border, then UP Bihar, we touched Nepal border, we moved to Bengal, and over there we touched the, you know, Bhutan border, and from there we went to Sikkim. We are engaging eminent people. We met with Baichung Bhutia. We went to Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, you know, Manipur, and Agartala. And today we are in Shillong, in your beautiful Meghalaya. From here, we have another 18 states, and we have little more than 1 month to cover all these states. The objective is of this campaign is to raise COVID awareness, you know, also to raise funds for, you know, COVID. We are requesting people to donate to this campaign Road Ashram. You can do that by logging into our website www.roadashram.in, and basically this health emergency has been converted in India into a huge humanitarian problem. So we are speaking with people from different walks of life and trying to find out how COVID has changed their life, how COVID has impacted their life, and doing a documentation of all this.
It has its own expenses, like we are spending on fuel, we are spending on food, we are spending on stay. So, and even as we are trying to keep it as basic as possible, it comes with its own need of resources, and the resources are being completely done from personal initiative. No one's funding us, no one is, there's no support as such. So yeah, it has a decent amount of...
sorry that this question pops up every time, you know, being a girl, you know, what are the main challenges for you?
Being a girl... I'm trying to think of something new to say. See, toilets are a challenge. Okay. These guys, I think, can still stand on the road and pee. And I am conditioned in a way where I am always feeling unsure and unsafe if I have to be on the road, and even if it's a quiet corner, I'm not sure. Then if you're on your period and you're driving, you know, it's constantly moving, your body pains, then the way we are built, like my body is swollen up because of dehydration and water retention. And I think sometimes there are just things that I might want to express and I cannot, because I think women have a certain way of expressing, and we are very expressive and we need to I mean, I don't want to generalize, but and female company is something you sometimes want just to hold someone, because women are also very like, you know, touchy and more physical, more comfortable physically. And but I'm also fortunate that I'm meeting a lot of women, and these both men are very, very caring. They make sure that I'm comfortable. They make sure that if the challenges I face, they are helping me out. As a woman, I won't talk about as a woman, but I think Road Ashram has become a very interesting place for me to deal with my mental health, because I'm a mental health patient. So being on the road and this journey is teaching me a lot. It's taking me out of my head and it's exposing me to others. Talking to people is very energizing. I'm seeing how much of our nation is greens. And when one defines what a nation is, one never says that, oh, my country is trees, my country is rivers, and that is perhaps why our environment is in such a state. So I think one needs to also go beyond. I mean, it's very important to talk about toilets. It's very important to talk about menstrual hygiene. So I'm just wondering that me with all my education, with all my privilege, if I struggle so much, I do not know what I cannot even imagine the condition of menstrual hygiene of people who are working day in and day out. And we know it's a challenge in this country. And we know toilet hygiene is a challenge in this country. So it's not just about saving girl child. It's not about educating women. It's also about ensuring the basics. So that is, I would like to locate that problem in that larger context. And perhaps Road Ashram is about bringing that context into the picture.